See, let us see X-linked dominant inheritance. So here we have seen in the last class X-linked recessive characters. So here now let us see X-linked dominant inheritance. See, what is X-linked dominant inheritance? X-linked dominant inheritance is a mode of inheritance of the character that is carried by the dominant allele. So in the X-linked recessive inheritance, the disorder or problem is carried by the recessive allele. But here that gene or any genetic disorder is caused by the dominant allele. Means if you take in the X-linked dominant characters, these are the disorders caused due to the presence of dominant alleles. Presence of dominant alleles means disorder is expressed by the presence of dominant allele. Presence of dominant allele. So here, what is the difference between the recessive inheritance or dominant inheritance? Sir, here we are taking dominant allele, means the disorder is carried by the dominant allele. Okay, so in this sense, one dominant allele is enough to cause the disease. One dominant allele. So one dominant allele is enough to cause the disease. Okay. Next one is, the dominant allele is present on the X chromosome. Okay. See here, let us see the probabilities of the genetic disorder. If you take this disorder, means if father is affected, so all the daughters are affected. Why? Because when a father has one dominant allele, that will give to the daughter. If father is affected, all the daughters are affected. Okay, next. If mother is homozygous affected, if mother is homozygous affected, all the children will be affected. All the children affected with the disease. Okay. Next thing is, in the females, one allele is enough. How many alleles are enough? One allele is enough for the disease. So why? Because female has two X chromosomes. If any one of these two X chromosomes have dominant allele, if any one of the X chromosome has dominant allele, that will cause the disease. So here, females have more chances for the disease. Okay. Next, if you take, males will be affected more due to the lack of compensating allele. So if you take male, what are the sex chromosomes? X, Y. When only one dominant allele is present on the X chromosome, the males are affected. But if they are heterozygous, there may be chance for the less effect of the disease in the individual. And actually, these are uncommon diseases. X-linked dominant characters are uncommon. They are rarely seen in the individuals. Let us see again, what are the X-linked dominant characters? What is X-linked dominant inheritance? The mode of inheritance of the dominant allele from one generation to the another generation is called as X-linked dominant inheritance. And dominant allele is present on which chromosome? It is present on the X chromosome. Which allele will cause the disease? Dominant or recessive? Dominant will cause the disease. The individual with one dominant allele on the X chromosome will be affected. Sir, if you look at the X-linked recessive, that required two recessive alleles for the disease in a female. Okay, but here one allele is enough for the disease. And here no female carriers. What is important character? There are no female carriers. When you will call female carrier? If female has one dominant allele, one recessive allele, she is said as carrier. But what happened in the X-linked recessive disorders, dominant disorders? One gene will cause the disease. There is no chance for the carrier. If one is present, affected in the female. If both are dominant alleles, also will be affected. Next, one dominant allele will cause the disease. No two alleles. One dominant allele is enough to cause the disease. And this dominant allele is present on which chromosome? That is present on the X chromosome. So, if father is affected, all the daughters are affected. Why? Because when X, only one X is present in the father, this X will go to what? Daughter. So, when father is affected, all the daughters will be affected. If mother is homozygous affected, homozygous means when the mother has two dominant alleles. When two X chromosomes have dominant alleles or diseased alleles, one will go to the daughter, one will go to the son. One is enough to cause the disease. So, daughter is affected, son is also affected. All the children will be affected. All the children will be affected. That is point. So, one allele is, one dominant allele is enough to cause the disease. Females have more chances because females get X chromosome from the mother as well as from the father. Females have two chances to get the X chromosome. Okay, they receive from father, they receive from mother also. So, then females have more chances for the disease. That is point. So, and males are affected, intensity of the disorder is more in the males. Why? Because if female has one dominant allele, one recessive allele, so there is a supplementation or complementation of the allele is there in the female. But whereas in the male, no choice because another sex chromosome is Y. So then, so males have more effect. If there are no female carriers, no chance for the female carriers. Why? If even the one allele is present in the female will be affected by the disease. Okay. So this is about characters of X-linked dominant alleles. Okay now. Let us see examples. These are some uncommon diseases. They are not common in the individuals. Very rare diseases these are. Okay na? So first one, let us see follicular hyperkeratosis. What is the first one? Follicular hyperkeratosis. So this one disease. So, follicular hyperkeratosis in the sense that is the excessive growth of keratin or excessive development, of keratin, okay, of hair follicles. So, means keratin is a protein and it is excessively produced. So, excessive development of keratin in hair follicles. In hair follicles, that is a symptom. Next, this leads to rough cone shaped elevated papules. So, rough cone shaped elevated papules. Elevated papules are formed. Okay. Next one, sometimes openings of these sweat glands. Our openings of these hair follicles will be closed. So, hair follicles will be closed by the encrusted sebum. So this is follicular hyperkeratosis. The name itself indicating, hyper means more, keratosis means keratin. So excessive development of keratin in the hair follicles that leads to the rough shaped, cone shaped, elevated papules formation. Next, encrusted sebum will close the openings of the hair follicles. So these are the symptoms of follicular hyperkeratosis. Okay, now next let us see. So incontinentia pigmentosa. So incontinentia pigmentosa, this is another X-linked dominant character in which progressive degeneration of melanin from the skin. So means it leads to the loss of pigmentation. And it is sometimes lethal. Lethal means sometimes it causes death. Sometimes it causes what? Death. So here means what is happening here? The melanin is lost from the skin. Skin becomes depigmented, loss of pigmentation. Sometimes it is lethal. But it is not lethal in the males. Not lethal in males. Okay, next if you see, generally if mother is homozygous affected or female, if female is homozygous affected, if female is homozygous affected, it leads to the lethal. It is lethal in the homozygous affected female. Let us see its genic expression.